Italian recipe, which is my favorite. That is Domino's style zingy parcel.
We'll see the ingredients for the dough. What we'll need? We'll need 1 cup of plain flour, that is maida. Here I have instant yeast. We'll need 1/2 teaspoon of instant yeast. Then I'll need little salt as per the taste. 1 tablespoon of sugar and little of oil. So some mixed herbs. These are optional, but it gives the best flavor. So firstly, we'll start by activating the yeast. Here I have 1/2 cup of water, warm water it is, and I'll take 1/2 teaspoon of instant dry yeast. See, this is 1/2 teaspoon of instant dry yeast. I'll add it to the water, put a little sugar to it, so that the yeast will activate with the help of the sugar. We'll just dissolve the yeast and the sugar, mix it properly, and now we will rest for 10 to 15 minutes until the yeast is activated. Okay, so after 10 minutes, you can see the yeast is activated. Now we will add our dry flour, plain flour, and also we will add little salt as per the taste. And we'll need a medium soft dough. We'll need the dough just as a chapati dough, little soft dough we will need. And also we will add some mixed herbs, chili flakes and oregano in the dough. This will give a nice flavor and aroma to the dough. Now we will add little oil and knead the dough for around 2 minutes. So our dough is ready. Now we'll apply little oil to the sides and just rest it for 1 hour or until it doubles in the size. Now our dough is resting for 1 hour. So meanwhile we'll make the filling. Now for the filling we'll need tomato, 1/2 tomato chopped finely, onion chopped finely, 1/2 capsicum chopped finely, boiled sweet corns 2 tablespoons, and chopped paneer. And then we will need in the spices mixed herbs, little salt, tomato ketchup, mayonnaise and olives. This is optional. And then we'll need also cheese. This is mozzarella cheese and cheese slice. So now we'll start making the filling. And I have added 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Once the oil is hot, I'll add onion and saute it for 2 minutes. Now I'll add little of ginger and garlic paste and saute it. The onion is little translucent now. I'll add capsicum and just cook it for 2 minutes. Our capsicum is cooked properly now. I'll add salt in it and mixed herbs, and now just cook it just 2 minutes. Now I'll add tomato and let it cook for 2 minutes. Now I'll add tomato ketchup 1 tablespoon and little mayonnaise, around 1 tablespoon of mayonnaise. Also, I'll add the boiled corns in it, and also I'll add chopped paneer, and now cook it for around 2 minutes. So now our filling is ready. Let's check on our dough. After 1 hour, you can see our dough is already double in size. Now we'll just knead the dough and start rolling out it. I just cut the dough in around 4 to 5 equal parts, and now we'll just start rolling. Now we'll dust little dry flour and just roll it out in round shape. Not too thick, not too thin. So now I'll just fold it in triangle shape this way. And again we have to just roll it out a little. So now this way again, now we will just at bottom we'll add little of cheese, and then we will add the filling which we have made. You can add little of olives and also little cheese again. You can add little of chili flakes if you like. And now we have to seal the edges. Take one edge and just fold it at the top, and then apply little water, and then just seal the another edge on the water, and again apply water on the second layer and seal the edge. So this way our parsley is ready. See, I have made all the zingy parsley, and now we will keep it aside for around 15 to 20 minutes so that it will just puff up, and then we will bake it. So after 15 minutes, just brush them with little milk so that it will get a brown crust, golden brown crust. So now I'll just bake this our zingy parsley in microwave at convection mode. I have preheated the microwave at 190 degree Celsius for 10 minutes, and now I'll bake at 190 degree in convection mode for 20 minutes or until you get a golden brown color. See, our zingy parsley is ready now, baked from the oven. You can see how the golden crust is there and melted cheese. Now I'll just brush little, I'll just apply little butter so that it gets a golden shine and yummy flavor. So let's see one of our zingy parsley. See how yummy and cheesy it is. Let's have a bite.